Yeah, she's got some nice long hair, and you know that she's a bad chick. All the boys there can't help it. Hello everyone, welcome again to my YouTube channel. So I am training yung Bidang Ventura Bukay. Now for this day we will discuss about the four branches of ballistics. So we all know that ballistics are part of the criminalistic subject, ba? Part siya ng criminalistic subject sa board exam. At so dito we will know what are the four branches of ballistics. So dito naka-scope, di ba? Dito naka-scope yung mga study on how the ballistics or the system of ballistics will be used in criminal investigation. So ballistics is the study of the motion of the projectile. So when we talk about the ballistics, ito yung dito natin ma-study yung mga motion ng projectiles, di ba? So ito yung definition ng ballistics. When we say motion, it refers to the movement or the mobility of the bullet. So yung movement ng bullet after niya lumabas sa barrel ng firearm is ito yung motion na tinatawag nila, di ba? When we talk about motion, ito yung movement ng bullet na nanggaling sa armas, di ba? We have different motion of the projectile or bullet. So these are the direct, rotary, and translational. So when we talk about the direct, forward movement of the projectile ito, di ba? Inside the gun barrel. So resulting from the expanding forces. So yung movement ng projectile inside the barrel, di ba? Because nag-move siya because of the expansion of gases, because yung combustion ng gunpowder ay na-trigger dahil yung primer ay in-strike, di ba? So ito yung tinatawag na direct. So ito yung forward movement of the bullet because of the expansion of forces, di ba? Of gases. So when we talk about the rotary naman, the gyrating action or the rotating, di ba? From the word rotation, it right or left or of the projectile while passing through a gun barrel. So because of the rifling, so may tinatawag tayong rifling, di ba? Inside the barrel. So ito yung dahilan bakit umiikot yung bala. So ito yung rotary, di ba? Ito yung rotary motion of the bullet. So when we talk about the translational naman, it is the straight line movement where every part of the projectile follows a parallel path, di ba? And no rotation takes place, such as bouncing of a bullet after hitting a resistant surface. So ito yung translational. When we talk about translational, ito yung effect, di ba? For example, nabangga ang bullet, di ba, sa target. So nag-bounce siya. So ito yung tinatawag nating translational. So yung movement ng bullet ay hindi dahilan ng pag-hit ng pin sa primer at sa expansion ng gases, but more on the effects of the bullet after the bullet na target yung target mismo. So ito yung translational, di ba? So ito yung dahilan bakit ballistics ang tawag. So it is more on the movement of the bullet from the internal, di ba, up to the target. So ito yung ballistics. So we'll proceed sa interior ballistics naman, di ba? Itawag itong interior or internal ballistics. It refers to the motion, the attributes and characteristics of the bullet while it's still inside the firearm. It extends from breech to muzzle point. So yung bullet ay nagaling sa sa magasin, di ba? Pinasok sa magasin load. So after ma-produce yung burning of gases, di ba? Dahil yung primer ay natamaan ng pin. So ito na ang tinatawag na interior ballistics, di ba? Yung mga aktibidades, yung mga activities of the bullet inside the barrel, di ba? So dito natin makikita from firing pin, di ba? Natamaan niya yung primer, di ba? Yung primer as a chemical composition. So it will create expansion of gases. At dito na nasusunog or na buburn yung powder. So as you can see with this itong nasa picture, di ba? Burning the powder, so na expand yung gases. Then the bullet moving down the barrel. So ito yung scope ng internal or interior ballistics. So we will proceed naman, talaga. How the cartridge works? Paano ba nag-work yung cartridge? So a blow from the firing pin to the primer is the tendency for the priming mixtures. Itong mga priming mixture is chemical composition ito, ba? Then it will be crushed against the anvil causing its ignition, which refers to percussion. So tinatawag nila itong percussion, itong burning of gases after the primer, di ba? Natamaan ng pin. So percussion ang tawag niya. Subsequently, the produced plane travels and passes to a vent or flash hole. Then that connects the priming mixture and gunpowder, causing the rapid and confined burning of gases or the gunpowder. So known as deflagration at about 0.000001 seconds. So itong mga activities na ito na itong mechanism na ito na nakikita natin sa internal ballistics, it is 0.0001 seconds lang, di ba? After niya ma-burn yung gunpowder. So ganun kabilis. So ang tawag naman nito is deflagration. Di ba? When the powder begins to burn, it produces an expansive force of gases, a pressure. So itong mga yung burn gunpowder is magpo-produce ng expansive force of gases, meaning lumalaki yung gas niya na nasa loob. So it will create pressure. So ito yung nagpo-push. Bakit yung bullet mismo is naghihiwalay sa kanyang cartridge. So ito yung nagpo-push, nagpo-force. So ito yung expansive force of gases. So ito yung dahilan bakit umihiwalay yung bullet sa case niya. So because of the gases, dahil sa pagsabog or yung pag-burn ng gunpowder na nanggaling sa primer, di ba? Itong kuan kasi itong primer is ito yung chemical composition wherein siya yung nag-initiate ng fire para masunog niya yung gunpowder, di ba? So once the bullet is forced outside to make firm contact with the bore, the cartridge case expanded as the pressure generated within to prevent the gas to leak. Reupward so that it would be confined within the chamber of the firearm. So the sealing of the barrel due to case expansion and bullet action is known as obscuration. So nagsisil yung barrel because of the bullet action. So ito yung tinatawag na obscuration, di ba? Obscuration naman ang tawag nito. So the small amount of expanded gas that would leak in between the body of the shell and the inner surface of the chamber wall is known as blowback. So ito yung small amount of expanded gas. Ang tawag naman nito is blowback. So the time during which the projectile is influenced by interior ballistics is very short, from the release of the firing pin to the moment the sound of the shot can be heard, as it leaves the muzzle occupies only about 0.01 seconds. So ito yung kwan, napakabilis, di ba, ng armas. Ito yung rate ng speed ng bullet from yung pin is to Bama, sa kanyang primer up to lalabas ito ng muzzle is 0.01 seconds lamang. So dito kabilis yung activity na nandyan sa internal ballistics, di ba? Then attributes of interior ballistics. So ito yun, di ba? After the ignition of the primer, nag-ignite yung primer, which is ang tawag is precaution. So the flames is produced. Combustion of the gunpowder, ito yung tinatawag na deflagration, di ba? Then energy that is generated. So yung kaibahan ng kuana to avoid doubt. Yung kaibahan ng percussion at deflagration is that itong percussion, ito yung ignition ng primer. So hindi magkapareho ang primer at yung ignition ng primer at ng so ito yung primer, di ba? Dito natin makikita yung primer. So hindi magkapareho yung ignition ng primer kasi na-stack ng pin. Tamaan ng pin, nag-ignite siya. So ang tawag dito is percussion. While yung combustion of the gunpowder, tinatawag naman itong deflagration. So ito yung combustion ng gunpowder. So magkaiba yung percussion at deflagration. You take note with this, di ba? Kasi lalabas ito sa vertex namin. Percussion is na-ignite yung primer, which is caused by the pin or the firing pin. Ito namang deflagration is may nangyaring combustion ng gunpowder. Combustion, di ba? So, ito yon. So, energy that is generated, force pressure developed, then the velocity of the bullet from the chamber up to the muzzle. So, yung velocity ng bullet chamber up to the muzzle is 0.01 seconds. Second lang, di ba? Rotation of the bullet from left or right, di ba? Nagdepende ito yung rotation ng bullet sa kanyang rifling. Kasi may tiyatawag tayo na class characteristics wherein yung different branch of the firearms is may tiyatawag na signature, di ba? May tiyatawag siya na characteristics na common sa kanila, di ba? For example, yung sa Glock, hindi pareho yung rotation ng lads and groups sa Glock, di ba? At yung ibang mga brand. So ganito 'yon. So rotation of the bullet depends on the brand. Engraving of the cylindrical surface of the bullet, impression of land and groups. So ito yung land and groups. So may tiyatawag din tayong transition ballistics. So hindi natin masyadong kikita itong transition ballistics, but it is an add-on, di ba? Sa kanyang branches wherein tiyatawag din itong intermediate ballistics. So the study of the projectile behavior when it leaves the barrel. So once nag-leave yung projectile or yung bullet sa barrel, tiyatawag dito natin ma-observe yung transition ballistics from the internal to the outside, di ba? So it is the area where the bullet leaves the barrel and it is on its own, di ba? Mechanically, it involves flash suppressor, sound suppressor, and recoil compensation filters, di ba? So walang mga factors na makukonsider natin ito kasi yung sa internal ballistics may mga factors. The class characteristics of the bullet, di ba? Yung pin, so may mga kanyan, may mga factors to be considered para malaman natin bakit lumabas yung bullet sa internal ballistics. Pero dito sa transition, so wala nang involved the force, di ba? So ito yung transition ballistics. So punta naman tayo dito sa external or exterior ballistics. When we talk about the external ballistics, it treats of the attributes or movement of the projectile after leaving the gun muzzle. So after the transition, so nandito na tayo sa external ballistics, di ba? It is extended from the muzzle from the gun to the target. So or any attributes to the motion of the projectile, it is in flight and before reaching the target. So while on flight yung projectile or yung yung bullet may mga involvement of factors, di ba? Kung mabibilisan ba ng bullet yung kanya, yung movement. So ganyan, may mga factors. So nandito natin makikita sa external ballistics. So kaya nga ito tinawag na external or exterior ballistics. Kasi while on site yung bullet, dito natin makita yung mga attributes of the projectile, either yung mga air, di ba, yung gaano kalakas yung hangin sa area. So ganyan, so may mga tinatawag tayong attributes of the exterior ballistics. Ito yung muzzle blast. This is the noise created at the muzzle end of the barrel of the firearm after the explosion. So muzzle blast ang tawag ito. Muzzle energy naman, energy generated at the muzzle point measured in foot pound. So ito yung energy. Trajectory naman refers to the parabola light flight of the projectile from the time it leaves the muzzle until it hits the target. So ito yung tinatawag na trajectory niya, yung direction of the bullet. So it is also described as the actual curve path taken by a bullet during its flight. So ito yung direction niya wherein saan pupunta yung bullet. So ito yung trajectory na tinatawag. So range, it refers to the imaginary straight distance between the muzzle. So ano gaano kalong yung distance, di ba, of the muzzle from the gun to the target. So may tinatawag tayong accurate range. When you talk about the accurate range, the distance within which the shooter or the gunner has control of his shots, meaning makontrol niya saan pupunta yung bullets, di ba? So ito yung accurate range. Effective range naman, the distance within which the barrel or the bullet is expected to be lethal. So gaano ka effective or gaano kalaki yung damage, di ba? Mas malaki yung damage na nagagawa ng bullet after hitting the target. So ito yung effective range. So maximum range naman, the distance that a projectile can be propelled from a firearm. So ano yung maximum range niya? For example, yung M16, gaano gaano kalayo yung distance na makaya niya. So ito yung maximum range. Maximum effective range naman, di ba? It is not only on the distance na makaya niya but also the how the bullet will be effective on the target, kung maigo, di ba, sa Bisaya pa. So ito yung maximum effective range. So velocity, may mga terms na may use natin dito sa external ballistics. Yung una is itong velocity. So it refers to the rate of speed of the bullet during its flight. So once na may lumabas sa bullet exam na rate of the bullet, di ba, while on flight, ito yung tinatawag na velocity, di ba? The rate of speed per unit of time usually expressed is feet per second. So may tinatawag din tayong pull of gravity. So it is the downward reaction of the bullet towards the earth surface due to its weight. So ito yung pull of velocity. So air resistance, gaya ng sinabi ko kanina, as I have said kanina, refers to the force of the air encountered by the bullet in its flight. So there are different factors to be considered if gaano gaano mo malaman as investigator gaano kalayo yung kuha niya, yung distance, because of these factors. While there are different areas wherein we must consider, di ba? For example, if yung resistance sa air niya is mas matindi, di ba? Malakas yung air sa area, yung pressure of air. So we will consider that, di ba, as investigator. So the penetration, the depth of entry on the target. So ito yung mga attributes na makita natin sa external ballistics. So these are the contributions of some of the personalities in terms of developing the external ballistics, di ba? So Englishman invented the ballistics pendulum, an instrument used to measure the muzzle velocity of any firearm, and we use one of the first to state sound ballistics theories in his new principles of gunnery in 1742. So he became the father of modern gunnery. Pendulum, meaning mamimissure ng instrument na ito gaano kabilis, di ba, yung velocity ng bullet. So it will actually use in investigation, kasi malalaman natin, di ba, as investigator makikita natin yung whole picture na paano ginawa ng criminal yung krimen, di ba, through this instrument. So invented another instrument used to measure bullet speed in chronograph. Kasi ito naman si Alfred Lee Loomis, si Benjamin Robbins ballistics pendulum, si Alfred Lee Loomis siya yung sa chronograph. So dito tayo pupunta naman tayo sa terminal ballistics. So it refers to the effects of the impact of the projectile, meaning it focuses more on the impact of the bullet to the target. So it extends from its initial contact towards the depthness of penetration on the target. So dito na makikita, di ba, yung usage ng ballistics sa investigation. Kasi if ever malaman natin gaano ano yung mga attributes ng ballistics na ito, di ba, so makikita natin dito na we will able to measure the distance between the target and the suspect. So attributes of the terminal ballistics: terminal accuracy, it refers to the size of the bullet grouping on the target, meaning yung gaano kalaki yung tinatawag nila na the grouping of the bullet na makikita natin sa victim. So meaning yung makikita natin dito gaano siya ka-accurate, di ba, if ever yung suspect is kwan talaga, di ba, magaling talaga sa pagputok. So ito yung tinatawag na bullet grouping. So mas maliit yung grouping of the bullet, so mas accurate yung pagbaril, di ba. So this is so because of some resistance interventions that make the bullet change its momentum to perform other motions rather than straight and hit the target partially or totally sideways instead of head on. Due to this effect, keyhole shot instead of spherical instruments might be created. So makikita natin dito yung keyhole shot. So the terminal energy is the energy naman of the projectile when it strikes the target. So the energy of the projectile is affected by three factors. May tinatawag tayong gunpowder content. So mas malaki yung content ng gunpowder, so mas malaki din yung effect ng terminal energy, di ba? Yung effect ng bullet doon sa victim, di ba? Doon sa target. So ito yung gunpowder content. So the length of the barrel, as the barrel of the firearm becomes longer, it provides confined solid mass of expanding gas. So mas mabilis siya, mas malakas yung impact niya. So the third factor is the additional force imparted by the air to accelerate. So the bullet's velocity of its direction goes with the direction of the bullet upon leaving basal point of the gun. So ito yung additional forces. So this additional forces siguro ginamitan pa ng mas mga instrument na makakapagbilis ng bullet. So ito yung additional forces. Then terminal velocity is the speed of the bullet upon penetrating the target. So this is governed by four factors, such as ito yung terminal energy, gunpowder content, barrel length, plus type and shape of the bullet. So ito yung terminal velocity. Terminal penetration naman refers to the depth of the bullet in the target. So gaano kalalim, di ba, yung nagawa ng bullet sa target, di ba? Hence when the bullet hit the target perpendicularly, bullet penetration is deeper in soft target than the hard target. So ito yung terminal penetration. So I think these are the ito yung mga branches of ballistics na kailangan nating pag-aralan. So it can be used in investigation kasi from the internal ballistics, which is makikita natin dito paano gumagana yung bullet, di ba? Dito natin ma-identify ano yung ginamit na firearms ng suspect. So makikita natin dito, di ba? Ma-identify natin yung suspect. So from the external naman, so makikita natin yung direction of the bullet, di ba? Gaano kalayo yung suspect from the target. So dito naman sa terminal ballistics, dito natin malalaman ano yung mga wounds, di ba? Ano yung mga gaano kalalim yung penetration ng bullet. So we will be able to identify sino yung may-ari ng armas because of these factors, di ba? May eliminate natin yung mga suspect na hindi talaga suspect. So ito yung branches of ballistics. So thank you everyone, and I will make videos again, di ba? Dito sa criminalistics na subject.